Hi guys, welcome to my channel. Today we're doing Man in the Moon, a classic, into a twist, into a variation on a gazelle with an elbow hold. This is a really nice little sequence if you're looking for something to mix up your inside the hoop choreography or if you want to incorporate Man in the Moon in an interesting way. It's also a nice way to show off your split if you have a nice split, but you don't have to have a full 180 degree split for it. But before we get started, I'll just remind you guys to please subscribe to my channel because it really, really makes a difference. I know it seems like simple, nothing thing to do, but it does help me out a lot when you guys subscribe and like videos, and I will be very, very grateful. All right, moving on, we're gonna do pro tips. My first pro tip is to keep your body close to the hoop. As you're going into the twist, it's tempting to kind of lean away from your leg before you grab it, but you want to really keep your body tucked into the hoop, keep it close to your leg. It's going to make it easier to reach your foot with your hand. My next pro tip is to press your ankle against the top of the hoop. That's going to help stabilize you and make you feel more secure, that little bit of pressure of pushing your leg against the hoop. And my third pro tip is to use your head. This is an oldie but a goodie, I say it a lot. Use your head to elongate the line of your body by looking towards your foot or upwards, and don't let your head just kind of be hanging out doing whatever it wants, because that's going to break off your line and make the whole position look a little bit weirder. So make a pretty position, use your head to elongate your line and look up or towards your foot. All right, let's break it down. Start sitting in the hoop. You're going to go into your Man in the Moon. I'm not going to talk about transitioning into your Man in the Moon here, but if you would like a refresher on that, then there is a tutorial that I've done for Man in the Moon linked at the top of your screen right now and also in the description of this video. From Man in the Moon, you're going to take one hand, this hand is on the opposite side of the hoop as your head, and place it on the top of the hoop. Next up, you're going to straighten the same leg as that hand. So I'm straightening the leg that is on the opposite side of the hoop as my head. Once that leg is straight, I'm going to reach around with my free arm and grab my foot. It's going to be easier to grab the inside of your foot, but if you want to grab the outside, that is also possible. Now at this point, I do need to pull my leg back towards the back of my shoulder, but it's not as huge of a flexibility thing as it looks like it is. What you're actually doing is pulling your leg slightly to the side. You're not really doing a full 180 degree flat proper aligned split here. You're actually doing a modified split by pulling your leg slightly out to the side. So although it looks like you're being crazy bendy and flexy, you can actually cheat quite a bit. After I've pulled that leg down, preferably lower than the level of the hoop, I'm pulling with my arm that is on the top of the hoop and then straightening my other leg behind the hoop. So the hoop should be touching the outside of my ankle. That's your full twist position. So take a minute to show this off because it's really pretty. But when you're ready, take that leg that is up and press it down, coming into a horizontal line with both your legs. This is the quote unquote split, but you'll see again that it's kind of twisted out of alignment. Once my legs are down into a horizontal line, or as close as I can get to that, I'm going to let go with my top arm, slide it down, and hook my elbow on the side of the hoop. When I'm ready, I slip that elbow off and grab the hoop with my hand. Then I can let go of my foot with my other hand and bring my straight leg in a big circle all the way around. The momentum of my leg will help me bring up my torso. And I'm seated back in the hoop, ready to move on with my choreography. Here's the whole thing again in real time so you can see how it works. This is a really nice little sequence. It's just an interesting variation on some classic moves, and it's a nice way to use your space inside of the hoop, which we sometimes forget about. And one more time, I'll remind you to please subscribe. That really helps me promote this channel. It helps other people find the channel, and I really appreciate it. So please do those things. And with that, I will see you guys next time.